Good evening, everyone, and welcome to tonight's Live with Bucky Live. My name is Sarah, and I'll be your host for tonight's session. So tonight, we're actually going to be talking about university housing and what you could expect in your experience for fall 2021. So we're going to be answering your questions live today. So I see that some people have already started to do this, but if you have a question, please drop it into the comment section of this live video, and we're going to get to it in just a moment. So I also wanted to mention that if you would like to watch a replay of this live stream, or honestly, any of our other live streams that we have on our other Live with Bucky Live sessions, be sure to check out our Live with Bucky Live page at go.wisc.edu/livewithbuckylive. So just another note, we also are getting together every single Thursday at 5:30 p.m. to talk about all sorts of different topics here in university housing. So next week, our schedule changed a little bit from what we had emailed out. We're actually going to be taking a break next week. And we will be back, though, on Thursday, June 10th to talk about student jobs in housing and what benefits and perks you could actually get from working where you live. So we're going to have a great panel of both students and staff to answer any questions that you might have. So if you're curious to see what other Live with Bucky Live sessions are on the agenda as well, be sure to check out that Live with Bucky Live page that is below there. So go.wisc.edu/livewithbuckylive, and you can see what else we have planned for June. So before we dive into questions, I want to introduce everyone to our great panel that is here to answer anything you might want to know. So I will start with myself. As I mentioned before, my name is Sarah, and I work in communications here at University Housing. So with that, I'm actually going to pass it over to Tanishka.
Hi, everyone. My name is Tanishka. I'm a housing ambassador. I work with the assignments office for tours and to answer all your emails and questions that you have. Now I will give it over to Pamela.
Gotta unmute myself. Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Pamela Lizoy. I'm a residence life coordinator. I'm a full-time professional staff member who works in residence life. I oversee the day-to-day operations in Smith Hall and our new-to-us edition of the Lowell Center. I supervise house fellows and our residence life team assistants to help build community in our residence halls and help everyone have a great experience living on campus. I get to partner with our awesome facilities and dining teams to ensure an awesome holistic experience for all of our residents. And with that, I'm going to pass it back to Sarah.
Thank you, Pamela. So as you see, we've got Tanishka. She's one of our great student ambassadors that works here in housing, and Pamela from Res Life. And they are here to answer your questions that you might have. So just another reminder, if you do have a question, now's the time to drop it into the comment section of this video. If by chance we don't get to it tonight, or honestly, you're watching this, the session ends and you're like, oh, I just really wish I had asked that. Don't worry about it. We've got a great way to get a hold of us. Just reach out to us through our contact us form. And you can access that by going to go.wisc.edu/housing-contact. So first, I think we're actually going to kick it off with a question here. So I'm going to bring Pamela back here on the screen. So I think this would be a great question for you, Pamela. And this question comes to us from D Carr. And they are asking, would like to know what freshmen should bring besides normal stuff. So meaning what's included in housing. So what's someone going to get in their room?
Yeah, that's a great question. So each room, depending on the number of occupants that are in a room, you will have a bed to sleep on. So don't bring a mattress or a bed frame. We already got that in the room for you. We will also have a desk. There's a chair that you'll need at your desk as well. And then we will also have like a bookcase or a hutch or some type of wardrobe for you as well, or a dresser. It really depends on which hall you'll be living in. And so you'll see on the page right now, we're pulling up our furnishings that really lists everything that's in your room. It also notes like that you will have a compact refrigerator in your room as well. We do not provide microwaves, so that you would have to bring on your own. own. But really everything that's in your room is listed. And then we also go ahead and list all of the approved appliances that you can bring, like your microwave, but also appliances that you should not bring just for like safety and fire reasons too. So you can leave that pizza cooker or hot plate at home. We don't need that here in our residence halls too. And so it goes on to list other like unique to you things like bedding and pillows and alarm clocks. Right. And if you feel the need to bring a futon, just make sure you're chatting with your roommates as well, so you both aren't trying to find a futon and you both bring futons. So we also have what Bucky would bring to campus checklist. So this is all noted on our website as well. So definitely take a look on there for any items that you might want to pack up to bring in August when you move in.
That's great, Pamela. Thanks a lot. The other thing is, I know we have really great 3D kind of walkthrough tours of halls. So I know we haven't done our hall assignments yet, but if you're kind of curious what other people bring to live in our halls, I would suggest checking those out. Do you see that students use those kind of frequently too, Pamela?
Yeah, definitely. And too, I know we also have pictures of like rooms. So you can see on the screen right now, there are pictures of singles, doubles. We'll have triples definitely next year as well. And so that communication with your roommates as well is super important ahead of time, just to know what everyone is bringing too. But this is a great example of what students currently have in their rooms too. It does give you a good idea of kind of how you can also lay out your room. The furniture is all movable in most of our residence halls, so you can really make it unique and make it your own home while you're living in the space.
Perfect. Thanks a lot, Pamela. So with that, we're actually gonna show you a little bit more about housing that hopefully will start getting this conversation really going here. So we're gonna kick things off today with a short little video tour that some of our residence halls, in the Lakeshore neighborhood, which is actually led by our two student ambassadors, Susie and Dexter. So with that, we're gonna show you just a short little video here.
My name is Susie, and I'm a student housing ambassador here on campus. I'm studying marketing, and I'm originally from Brookfield, Wisconsin.
And my name is Dexter, and I'm also a student housing ambassador here with UW-Madison. I'm studying economics and history, and I'm originally from West Hartford, Connecticut. Today, we'll be taking you on a tour of some of our residence halls here in the Lakeshore neighborhood, and we'll get to see it in the gorgeous winter weather. We'll also be offering you a glimpse at some of the services we offer here in housing. So come on, let's check it out.
UW-Madison residence halls house over 7,800 students, with over 6,800 being first-year students. UW-Madison has no on-campus living requirement for any of your years. However, over 90% of our first-year students choose to live with us, with some returning in years following. Students live in one of two neighborhoods, either the Lakeshore neighborhood that we're currently in or the Southeast neighborhood on the other side of campus. Both neighborhoods house roughly the same number of residents. The Lakeshore neighborhood has more buildings with smaller concentrations of residents, and it's located on the shores of Lake Mendota next to the Lakeshore Path, near Camp Randall Stadium, and other outdoor recreation opportunities.
The Southeast neighborhood is located near the Cole Center, the Wisconsin State Capitol, and Bascom Hill. In total, UW-Madison has 21 residence halls, including 11 learning communities, 3 additional communities, and 5 dining locations.
Learning communities are residential spaces that bring together faculty, students, and staff around a specific focus. Here in Adams Hall is the International Learning Community. Adams is also home to 7 language immersion houses. Adams and neighboring Tripp Residence Hall have mostly single rooms, with some doubles and triples available as well. Additionally, Tripp is home to our transfer house, which allows transfer students to start building community right when they get on campus.
Common spaces, social lounges, and study dens like this one are located in every one of our residence halls. In addition, the Greenhouse Learning Community is located right here in Leopold Residence Hall. Looking for a job? Every year, over 2,000 students work with housing. Apply today at go.wisc.edu/student-jobs.
Laundry rooms, like this one in Leopold, are located inside or next to each residence hall. Residents can scan their WISC card, which is their official UW-Madison photo ID, to pay for washers, and dryers are free. Your WISC card is also used for things such as building access, dining, printing, and a few other things as well.
This is a resident room in Leopold. Rooms in newer halls like Leopold feature walk-in closets, higher ceilings, and controllable air conditioning and heat. Similar newer halls like Leopold include Ogg and Smith in Southeast and Dejope in Lakeshore. Each resident in a room is provided a mattress, loftable bed, desk, desk chair, bookcase, hutch or wardrobe, and dresser or built-in shelves.
Other resident rooms are more traditional, like this one in Cole. In addition to furniture, we also provide for each room compact refrigerators with two-in triples and quads, window coverings, closets or wardrobes, mirrors, wastebaskets and recycling bins, streaming TV, and high-speed wireless access points in each room with wired Ethernet connections available.
This is the hall desk for Cole and Leopold, located in Holt Center. Your hall desk is where you can get your mail, pick up packages, check out supplies and equipment, resolve key and WISC card issues, get information on campus or local areas, and much more.
And here we have Dejope Residence Hall. Dejope is our only residence hall not named after a person.
Dejope is a Ho-Chunk word meaning four lakes, which is what the Ho-Chunk called this area because of the chain of four lakes nearby.
In many of our residence halls, Dejope included, we offer convenient locations for many different campus services, such as this University Health Services Satellite Clinic, classrooms, computer labs with printers, and group studying and tutoring spaces.
Cross-college advising offices like this one are also located within many halls. They offer help with choosing classes, majors, careers, and more. In addition, all our hall communities have a residence life office where live-in professional staff, trained in building community, and house fellows, our version of RAs, are available to answer your questions.
There's one large dining market like this one in each neighborhood with three smaller locations spaced throughout campus. All marketplaces offer a variety of healthy and delicious options and convenient hours of operation. Bean and Creamery coffee and ice cream shops and Flamingo Run convenience stores are available in some locations as well. Lastly, a Starbucks is available in Smith Residence Hall.
All new residents must select a dining plan tier for food purchases for the year. Purchases are a la carte, but residents must deposit a minimum amount of money into a resident food account on their WISC card. There are three tiers to choose from. All residents receive a 30% discount on prepared food and a 20% discount on prepackaged food. For those with dietary restrictions, nutrition and allergy info is posted in our dining locations and on our website. We also have a registered dietitian on our staff to work to accommodate all of your needs.
After you're admitted to UW-Madison, you receive an email from University Housing inviting you to log in to MyUW Housing. From there, you'll be asked to enter your hall preferences. You must preference two learning communities and eight residence halls. Your assignment will then come out during the summer. For roommates, you can choose to either have a random roommate assigned to you, or you can list a preferred roommate. Many students use social media to find their roommate, but many students also find success in the random roommate process. In the summer, you'll attend student orientation, advising, and registration, and then you'll be all set to move in late August or early September. We'll be in contact via email the entire way, getting you important information and helping out by answering any questions you might have.
We're working with campus and local health officials to prepare for many additional scenarios as the COVID-19 pandemic continues. As of now, we anticipate returning primarily to in-person instruction for the fall 2021 semester, subject to change.
We're hopeful that the Live with Bucky experience will be more similar to a typical year next year, with some limited capacity in-person events available, but that of course is also subject to change.
No matter what our plans are, we'll make sure to communicate them with you via our website, social media, and email.
As always, please don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions at all. Take care, stay safe,
and on Wisconsin. Wisconsin.
Welcome back, everyone. So I hope that little video helped kind of maybe answer some of your general questions. But with that, we've got them all flowing in here. So we're going to jump right into getting these taken care of for you tonight. So I'm going to bring Tanishka back here. And I have a question for you, Tanishka, that's coming from Robert. So Robert is asking, I think a lot of parents are wondering about the calendar, the dates when assignments are going to be handed out. Can you speak a little about when people should expect to see their hall assignments?
Yes, that's a great question. So we are expecting that we will have the hall assignments out sometime mid-summer. We are expecting more in mid-July. So make sure you are keeping an eye out on your email, and we are taking this time so that we can make sure we have everything ready for you. We are prepared with the room assignments. We are prepared with the policies that will be in place so that we can welcome you here and give you your assignments. With your assignments, you will also get your move-in day and information regarding when is your move-in, what time slot you have. And our specific move-in dates are August 30th till September 2nd. So wait for that. And I know we all are very excited to be here, book our flights. Just keep looking out for your email. We will be there soon.
Thanks, Tanishka. And I think, too, it's really important to know the reason that it's coming out kind of mid-summer, mid-July-ish is really because we're waiting for those health protocol policy decisions that are really being made by UW-Madison right now. That is the most important thing, is to keep you guys safe and healthy. And with that, I think as soon as we have those together, we'll be able to get those assignments out to you. We know how exciting it is, right? You get to hear that all the time, Tanishka. All right. So thanks a lot, Tanishka. I think with the next question, I'm going to bring Pamela in here. So Pamela, we have a question from Dragon, and they are asking, does it cost extra to have the bed lofted?
Great question. It does not. So when you move on campus, if you feel comfortable enough to loft your bed, our house fellows have mallets, or you can also pick up a mallet. It's like a little hammer that doesn't damage our furniture. And you can loft your bed yourself, or you can also submit a request into our maintenance team, and they'd be able to help assist you loft your bed too. But it does not cost extra. Good question.
Thanks a lot, Pamela. With that, I think I'm actually going to have you field another question for us since I have you here. So this question comes to us from Aslam, and they are asking, are there kitchens in the floors of the dorms or something? So what access do people have to kitchens?
Yeah, great question. So each of our halls are unique in terms of how many kitchens we have and where they are located. So definitely check out our website and look at each hall's page. It does note all the amenities that halls have. So Smith Hall, specifically where I work, they do have kitchens on each floor. However, Whitty Hall, one of our halls also still in Southeast, has one nice big kitchen in the basement that all the residents get to share too. So definitely go ahead and look online at all of our hall pages. Right here, you can see Smith Hall, for example, has more information about the hall, and then it also includes nearest dining, where laundry is, and also, of course, the kitchen. So definitely take a look into that.
Thanks a lot, Pamela. I want to bring Tanishka back in here for the next question. So Tanishka, this question comes to us from Daniel. And Daniel is asking, if two people agree to be roommates but are accepted into different learning communities, will they still dorm together? Can you kind of talk about preferred roommates and how that works?
Yes. So we all, while filling up the information, you had the option to have rank your residence halls and then ranking your learning communities. After that, students could choose which one do they prefer more. Do you want to really be passionate about your living in the certain residence hall you ranked or the learning communities? If you have a preferred roommate, we make sure that you guys are together and give priority to you and your roommate instead of the residence halls. So in the case that you're a preferred roommate, you will be assigned a room together. You will be in the same learning communities, as learning communities are residence life, live-in spaces.
So if your roommate and you would not be assigned to separate learning communities because your roommate preference is what would be that priority, correct? So you're not going to be, okay. So just to clarify that, you're not going to be assigned to one learning community and the other. You guys would be assigned together. Okay, perfect. Thank you, Tanishka. I have another question for you, I think, while we have you here. This question is really about internet speed. So I don't know if, do you know enough about internet speed that you can speak to a little bit about this? So this question comes to us from Aiden, and they are asking, is there information regarding average up and down speed? So how good is our internet within the halls?
So I lived in residence halls for 2.5 years of my college. So I was there in my freshman and sophomore year. I personally never had any problem with internet. Every room has their own connection. You can even bring a modem with you if you want to. And the average up and down speeds, this information can be readily accessed on DoIt. DoIt is our official technology questions, everything there. So you can find that. But personally, connecting 4 devices, I never had any problems with that.
Also, I do know that our IT services did install what are called HAPs, right, which are personal access points within each room. So those are there that you have the ability to really tap into that high-speed internet. So if you're doing a lot of live streaming and things on other gaming systems, you should be good to go, which is great. So that was something they did a lot of updating with. So thanks, Tanishka. So I think with that, I'm going to bring Pamela back here. And Pamela, we have a question about bikes and bike racks. So this comes to us from L. Lifeman, and they are asking, is there bike parking or bike racks? What is there and where people could park those?
Yes, great question. And Madison is super bike friendly, so definitely bring your bikes. We do have bike racks. Usually they are located right next to the residence halls, if not just a few steps away from them. Definitely bring one of those U-locks and lock it up so it doesn't decide to just roll away and join somebody else. But yes, definitely bring your bikes. There are bike racks available for you to lock your bike up next to your hall when you're not riding it around our beautiful campus.
Yes. And if you're on the lakeshore and you are riding on the lakeshore path, that is like the most beautiful way to get across campus right on the lake. So I highly suggest that. So while I have you here, Pamela, I got a great question that just came in from Abby. And Abby is asking, are there opportunities within each residence hall for students to get to know each other and interact? So how do people connect?
Yeah, great question, Abby. So we have lots of staff here, student staff and professional staff ready to help you get to connect with other folks who live in your halls and even across campus. We have lots of programs that we're hoping to do. We also have a calendar that will note different events going on at different times around campus or around campus and around our residence halls too. So within your hall, you'll be able to get to meet folks who live in your house or on your floor. Your house fellow would be a great person to connect with about just meeting your neighbors. If you don't feel comfortable just going over and knocking on the door and introducing yourself. We also have Residence Life team assistants who will plan for our entire communities, your whole building, or if there's like three buildings next to each other, do it for the whole community too. We have learning community programming assistants who program specifically for learning communities. We also have our Wisconsin late night events that are happening every Friday and Saturday. So you can even meet folks who live over in a different neighborhood. If you live in Southeast, you can meet somebody who lives over in Lakeshore, meet up for lunch because you met at a late night event. So lots of different opportunities that you'll be able to meet and get to know other folks on campus.
That's great. I've heard one of the most popular late night events is a grocery bingo. Is that true?
I would say grocery bingo is pretty hopping. Yes.
And what's the most favorite thing you give away at grocery bingo?
Oh my gosh. I don't know. You'd have to ask the students.
I heard like Cheetos and ramen soup and like all of those really dorm friendly things are
great.
Lots
of good snacks.
Yeah. Thanks, Pamela. Okay. This next question I actually have for Tanishka. So Tanishka, I'm wondering if you could help out Monique. Monique is asking, is there a cost for printing? So how does printing work in the halls?
That's a great question. You will definitely have access to really good printers. We have something called TLC, also called Technology Learning Centers. They are present in, you know, each neighborhood. We have one or two or three, depending on which neighborhood you are, which building you are. Usually they are few minutes of walk away. And at the TLC, you can use your WISC card, which is your student ID and also works as a debit card. And you can print one page for 7 cents. So it's pretty cheap and you can easily print as much as you want.
Thanks a lot, Tanishka. I know those TLCs might be merging into just printing centers, but either way, you're going to have access to those. So that's not something you need to worry about at all. So I actually have another question for you, Tanishka, and I think this is a good one to talk about. So this comes to us from Mary Jane, and Mary Jane is asking, how are decisions made as to dorm assignments? Is it a lottery system? Is it based on when a student submitted their housing preferences? So all housing preferences were due May 1st, right? And that included what that were due?
So everything, including your roommate preferences, your residence hall preferences, or your learning community preferences, all of them were due on May 1st. And after they are done, neither me nor Sarah, no one is touching them. It will all go through a lottery process. So it doesn't matter if you signed up on February 3rd or just a night before on April 29th. All of it goes through a lottery process, and through the lottery, we will get all of the information out, and then we will be sending it out to you guys.
Yeah, and it's really that philosophy so that we can give everyone an equal chance to really get anything on their preference list or off, right? What are the chances, since I have you here, of getting your top hall, right? We want to be in, say, OG. What are my chances of doing that? I'm sure you get that question a lot, too.
Yes, so let's say OG has 600 spaces, right? And this year, let's say about 700 people said OG is their first preference. They really want OG. So this random lottery will choose the 600 people who will get AUG, and the other 100 people might get something in their second choice, third choice, or somewhere there in their preferences. Everyone will be still guaranteed a spot with university housing, and at the end of the day, it's what you make of the experience. So let just the lottery roll.
Yeah, and that's really it, is that if you've signed a contract here with housing, we're going to guarantee you a spot here in university housing. And those numbers just don't add up, right? If you have, I know some of our top preference halls, sometimes people, we've been at 1,500 people who preferenced it, and there's 700 spots. So there's just logistically no way you can put 1,500 people in that hall safely. So I know that's a hard message to hear, but that's kind of what we do. And that's why it is a lottery system to try to equal that out. So thanks a lot, Tanishka. I know that's a big question people have. So with that, I'm actually going to bring Pamela back on here to answer a transportation question. So this question actually comes to us from God. Kind of crazy. So God is asking, is it most convenient to use a bike, or is there another form of transport that is better? So there's, you said it's bike friendly. What other options do people have?
Yeah, great question. Biking, definitely an option. You can also walk. I know we mentioned the Lakeshore path already, just to walk down to classes. We do have the bike path on the southeast side, just to like walk around campus too, or walk to the lakes. We also have a bus system that's included for all of our residents and living in the residence halls. You have access to the 80 is what we call it. You can jump on the bus, do a loop around campus, get to class, come back to class just by jumping on the bus. A lot of students also have mopeds. If that's something you already have and want to bring, definitely work with our parking and transportation partners to get a permit for that, so you can park it here on campus. Otherwise, just walking, I would say it's usually really gorgeous and there's lots to look at. And with a lot of our buildings looking as phenomenal as they do, you'll easily get to your destination before you even know it. So yeah.
Yeah, you kind of figure out your walking path too. And in the summer, that bus loops, so it's the best thing to do. So with that, I'm actually going to ask you another question here, Pamela. So this question comes to us from Pequin, and they are asking, is there an additional fee for the campus gym? So I know there's different Rockwell facilities, such as the NIC and other places. How do students access those?
Yeah, that's a great question. I believe it is a part of their student fees, and correct me if I'm wrong, but you do have access to our campus gym, specifically the one that we just finished that looks phenomenal over in my neighborhood in Southeast is the NIC, the Nicholas Recreation Center. Really pretty building. I believe you just need to bring your WISC card, and you'll be able to scan in and use all of the different facilities that they have. Their website would be awesome in terms of learning or knowing what's all available and when their hours are as well. So you can see there's also the Shell, which is right next to Camp Randall. So if you're walking towards Camp Randall, stop at Shell. I know there's like a really cool basketball court in there and ice rinks if you're into that. Lots of outdoor spaces as well, like the Near East Fields if you like playing just an open wide grass area, if you're into ultimate frisbee, or if you're at the Near West Field and you want to play on turf and kick the soccer ball around, lots of options with our Recwell friends that they'll get you going and get you motivated.
Yeah, they have really great group fitness classes too. So I think they were doing a lot of really great virtual options during this past year for COVID, but I mean, it's really fun to get out there. So
yeah,
thanks,
I did one of the yoga classes and it was great.
Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can squeeze in a couple more questions here, you guys, because I know you got them coming in fast and furious. So with Pamela here, I'm gonna have you field David's question here. So David is asking, are showers and bathrooms private? How does that work in the halls?
Yeah, great question. So depending on the type of hall you live in, again, it is different. So specifically with the halls that I've worked with, Witte and Smith, I'm going to go back to. Witte has community style bathrooms. And so they do have gender neutral bathrooms as well. It's just like one bathroom pod that has a toilet and a shower in, and you're just the one person in there. And then we also have those community bathrooms as well, seen on the screen right here. And so we have a row of toilets, and then the showers are in the back of the stall as well. There are dividers too, so you're not just standing out in the open. You can pull the curtain shut, take your shower, bring your shower caddy too. So that's our community style bathroom. And then we do have pod style bathrooms as well. So that's what we have in Smith. And so you're sharing the bathroom with a pod of other rooms that are really right next door to you. Again, it's a shower and a toilet that you would be sharing. There's a door on the bathroom as well. And so, yes, I would say they are private.
Yes, they are private stalls. So you won't, it's not like a room with just toilets lined up. You do have privacy. Yeah, that's really important. Thank you, Pamela. I'm going to squeeze in a question here for Tanishka. So Tanishka, I think this is a good one. So this comes to us from Nandini, and they are asking, are we allowed to have a preferred roommate after the deadline? So I think they're referring to the May 1st deadline, Tanishka. So can you change your preferences now?
So we had a strict deadline for when we can 100% guarantee you and accommodate your request, which was again May 1st. And I just wanted to quickly clarify, May 1st was a deadline, but because the weekend happened that time, so we were even accepting requests up until May 3rd. So yes, if someone submitted it on May 3rd, that's okay too. Yes, are we allowed to have a preferred roommate after the deadline? We will. You can send us your request, but we cannot 100% guarantee that we can make it work because, again, the preferences, we have so many students and the preferences deadline was along with the general deadline, which happened to be May 1st.
Thanks a lot, Tanishka. So I'm going to squeeze in one more question here. So I'm going to bring Pamela back here. So Pamela, this question's from Jen, and I think it's perfect for you. So Jen is asking, I've heard a hotel is being converted into university housing. Is this true? If so, how many students will be living there? So can you tell us about the Lowell Center?
Yeah, I would love to. We're very excited to be able to have more spaces for all of the students that really want to live on campus with us and being able to partner with our great campus partners by being able to take advantage of this awesome opportunity with our stakeholders that are willing to work with us through this. So you'll notice right now on the screen, you can see Lowell, we're planning to have about 250 residents. There is a mix of single, double, and triple rooms available. I will say most of the singles have already gone to our returning residents because they were super excited to get into this building as well with us. So I know previously there was a pool. The pool is not open, so sorry, but we do have views of the lake as well. And so we're going to be in competition with Waters and our other Lakeshore residence halls for the best lake view, maybe. But we do have some awesome spaces that we're excited to have students living in. And this also would be a great opportunity for students to have their own bathroom. And so I know I just talked about private bathrooms. There are bathrooms, as you would expect in any hotel room, to be included right into the room. So if you really don't want to share, Lowell would be a great place as well. To have your own bathroom and just share with only your roommates too. And so the room layouts are tentative. They all vary by floor, but definitely a great opportunity for our students just to continue living on campus. We'll have house fellows living in Lowell as well and programming going on. And so a front desk as well to check out equipment and study spaces available and programming spaces, as well as a dining center in Lowell for all of the residents living there. And so really exciting opportunity, and we're really thankful for our campus partners to work with us for this opportunity.
Thanks, Pamela. I know it's a great location too. So I think the Lowell Center will be a great addition to what we can offer this year. So unfortunately, that actually brings us to the end of our session tonight. I want to reassure you, though, we are going to be answering some questions in your chat as this continues in the comments. So stay posted for that. Also, we will, if you wanted to watch a recorded version of this live chat, it will be available afterwards at go.wisc.edu/livewithbuckylive. I also have noticed there's lots of roommate questions about that we didn't get a chance to address, such as what do we do if we don't get along with our roommate? What sort of resources are there? I want to encourage you to go to that Live with Bucky Live page, and we did a whole live stream about roommates and how to get involved with them. A lot of these questions too about how assignments and preferencing work, we also have live streams about that. So I encourage you to go and check those out. It's gonna help you get your questions to your answers as quickly as possible. In addition, if you do have something that you think of that you would like to ask after this live stream, or you just something else came that was really important, please reach out to us through our contact us form. We are going through this daily and making sure that we get back to you as fast as possible. You can get to that at go.wisc.edu/housing-contact. And also there were some specific questions about individual circumstances that were asked in the chat, and this would be a great place to put them because we will be able to address those. So with that, I wanna bring Tanishka and Pamela back here and really thank you for joining us tonight. Tanishka and Pamela are encouraging you to come join us for additional Live with Bucky Live chats. We're going to be doing one, remember, on the 10th on student employment. On the 17th, we're actually going to do managing and paying your bills. So all those questions about deadlines and payment and tuition, it's a great one to attend. So that'll help you. So with that, thank you so much for joining us tonight and have a wonderful evening. And we look forward to welcoming you on campus soon.